Squeaks and I are making different funny faces for some photos. Let's try a really silly face. Ready? Okay, now a really sad face. Let's try a surprise face. Oh, can you guess this one? That's right, it's my angry face. Could you tell that I looked angry? There might have been some clues that gave it away. I did move my eyebrows down, and I had a pretty big frown. When people feel angry, many of us have some of the same reactions. Think about the last time you were angry. Maybe you lost a game or asked for something and a grown-up said no, and suddenly you start to feel a bit mad. You might clench your teeth together, your stomach might hurt a bit, and you start breathing fast. My face scrunches up, even pretending to do all those things. Anger is a really powerful emotion or feeling, and when you feel angry, your body starts to do different things all at once. Our bodies are great at taking care of us and preparing us for anything that could be seen as a threat. In other words, something that might be bad for us. When you get angry, your brain starts sending messages to the rest of the body that there might be a threat coming, even if all that happened was that you lost a game or didn't get something you wanted. But your body wants to keep you safe. Even if you're angry about something that isn't a big threat, your body starts to react as though there might be danger or a fight about to happen. Your brain sends the signals out to get angry and fast. First, putting on an angry face warns others that you're mad. Clenching your jaw and frowning are signs that tell possible threats to back off. Many other animals have special ways of showing that they're angry. Dogs growl, cats arch their backs, and apes clench their jaws and bare their teeth like us. Huh, I didn't know that. When Squeaks gets mad, he might start squeaking louder, trying to sound big and tough. Sometimes just showing that you're angry might be enough to scare off a threat. If the threat doesn't go away, and if you stay angry, your body will move on to other stages of preparation. Your body gets ready to fight. This is when you might start to feel funny, because your body can take over a bit more here. Your body puts all of its energy into being ready to fight, so it stops working on things like digesting food. This can make your stomach hurt. Your eyes focus in on whatever is making you mad, noticing any changes or possible starts to a fight. Your brain even sends out messages to release adrenaline, a special chemical that can help you react more quickly, move faster, or fight harder throughout your body. In just a minute or two, you're ready to face off against any big threats. It is amazing how well our bodies work to protect us, but most of these reactions aren't needed for many of the things that make us angry from day to day. Our anger instincts are there to keep us safe if something really bad were to happen, but most of the time, we don't have to fight if we're angry about something. If someone disagrees with me or I'm disappointed because I lost a game, getting into a fight isn't the right choice for me to make. It can be hard when you're feeling angry or upset to make good choices because your body is running on overdrive trying to keep you safe. But sometimes we might need to find a way to control angry feelings and instincts. Well, Squeaks, if I'm feeling angry, I try to take a few deep breaths and sometimes I'll count to 10 really slowly to give my brain and my body time to cool off before I decide what to do. I also try to make sure that I get enough to eat and plenty of sleep. When people are tired or hungry, they can get angry much faster. Maybe you can try out these tricks the next time you get angry or frustrated and see which one works for you. Oh, and Squeaks, let's try one last photo. Let's do a big cheesy smile. You ready? Thanks for exploring with us today. Do you have any tips or tricks when you're feeling angry? Do you have any questions about other feelings? We have a website where you can send them. Just ask a grown-up to help you go to patreon.com/scishowkids to check it out. And we'll see you next time here at the fort.